Welcome. I am Avdesh Kumar Mishra. Today we are going to talk about the linguistic diversity in India. Friends, you must have visited other places other than your own hometown or village, and you must have seen people speaking different languages. Let me tell you that you will be surprised to know that India has so many mother tongues and languages. We have already discussed some other time that the Census of India records languages and mother tongues spoken by various people in various parts of India, and the difference between mother tongue and language is that all languages are essentially mother tongues. That means the languages that we speak at home, and all the languages start as mother tongue, but all mother tongues are not languages. Some mother tongues, they become language when they become a standard and they start to be used in mass media, education, administration, judiciary, etc. So that way we have two-tier system. The all mother tongues are listed by Census of India, and then some mother tongues are grouped under certain languages on the basis of the similarity and other criteria as decided by the Census of India. You will be knowing that we have now so many states and union territories, and there were so many censuses in the past. In the modern India, after independence, we had the first census in 1951, and then we had the next census in 1961, then 71, 81, 91, 2001. And the data for the languages and mother tongues have been published. All the details of all the mother tongues are not always published by the Census of India. After 1961, the mother tongues and languages which are spoken by more than 10,000 persons only are published, and others, the names of others and the number of speakers for other mother tongues and languages are not published. But as we know, on the basis of the census 1961, in 1961 we had 1652 mother tongues in India, which of course included about 103 or 104 foreign mother tongues. And right now, on the basis of 2001 census, we know that there are about 1600 mother tongues, which also include about 103 or 104 foreign mother tongues. So we can safely say that India has more than 1500 languages and mother tongues which are spoken in different parts of the country. And all these mother tongues and languages belong to four major language families, and they are Indo-Aryan, Dravidian, Austroasiatic and Tibeto-Burman. There are two other minor language families, namely the Andamanese family and the Thai-Kadai family. Andamanese family has some languages which are spoken primarily in Andaman and Nicobar Islands, and most of which have become extinct as the speakers of those mother tongues have already died. Then Thai-Kadai, mostly they are located in Assam and neighboring areas like Thai Phake, Thai Nora and so on, and they also have only 5 or 6 in India. The major language family in India is Indo-Aryan, which has so many languages, more than a few hundred. For example, we have Hindi, Assamese, Bangla, Odia, Gujarati, Marathi, Konkani, even Sinhalese in Sri Lanka. So all these are Indo-Aryan languages. Then we have Dravidian, and most of the languages are located, of the Dravidian family, are located in South India. And we have examples of Tamil, Telugu, Kannada, Malayalam, and even some Dravidian languages spoken in other parts of the country. For example, Kuruk or Urao, spoken in Jharkhand, Chhattisgarh, West Bengal, and even Andaman and Nicobar Islands. And we also have Malto, spoken in Jharkhand again, Jharkhand and Bihar and West Bengal. Then the third major family is Austroasiatic, and Austroasiatic languages are again located in various parts of country, and the major languages in Austroasiatic are Khadiya, Munda, Mundari, Ho, Santali and many other languages. We have one Austroasiatic language, namely Khasi, which is spoken in Meghalaya and partly in Assam, and they belong to a subgroup, subfamily of Austroasiatic known as the Mon Khmer branch, the Mon Khmer subfamily. And Khasi is the only representative of that subfamily in India. And lastly, we have Tibeto-Burman. Again, there are hundreds of Tibeto-Burman languages, but most of them are found in the Northeast Indian part. For example, the states of Assam, Arunachal, Sikkim, Tripura, Manipur, Meghalaya, Mizoram, we find hundreds of Tibeto-Burman mother tongues and languages. Some examples are, we have Bodo, Khasi, Mizo, Paite, Gangte, Manipuri, and so on. Because we have so many languages and mother tongues in India, that's why this country is called a multilingual country. And we have so much diversity, as you have already seen, that we have languages from Indo-Aryan, we have languages belonging to Dravidian family, Austroasiatic family, and Tibeto-Burman family. Multilinguality has never been a problem in India. We have the multilingual society existing from time immemorial. There was no point in time that India had only one language. There must have been at least two, three, or four languages all the time. And as we just now saw, that we have more than 1,500 mother tongues spoken in India right now. So we can safely say that multilinguality is an integral part of the Indian temperament. And as you know, language and culture are intertwined. So the moment we have so many languages and mother tongues, we also have almost equal number of cultures, because every language is enshrined in culture and vice versa. So culture and language are interdependent. So that's why we have so many cultures, so many languages in India. Now let's see some more examples of the languages and mother tongues existing in different parts of India. I'll give you some examples from some states. For example, Arunachal Pradesh. So we have Adi, Akka, Apatani, Bangni, Bogun or Bogum, Hilmiri. Hindi is also spoken there. Khamba, Kongbo, Khamti, Lisu, Meyer, Mizi, Muktum, Mishmi, Monpa, Na, Nishang, Nisi, Nokte, Puroik or Sulung, Shedukpen, Singpo, Tagin, Taram, Tangsa, Tutsa, Wancho, Jakring, and so on. Some example of Assam, let's see. So we have a scheduled language, Assamese there. Then Bengali, Vishnupriya, Manipuri, Bodo, Chakma, Deuri, Dimasa, Garo, Hajong, Mar, Kabui or Rongmai, Karbi or Mikir, Koch, Tiwa, Mishing, Nepali, Rabha, Sonowal Kachari, Thai or Man, Zemi, etc. Now let's look at some languages of Andhra Pradesh. We have Adivasi Odia, Banjara, Chenchu, Gadwa, Goni, Jatapu, Khon or Kond, Kolami, Konda, Koda or Kora, Koya, Kui, Kuvi, Marathi, Savara, Tamil, Telugu, Urdu, Yerukala, and so on. Languages in Chhattisgarh and mother tongues, we have Agariya, Baigi, Bharia or Bhumia, Bhatra, Bhili or Vilala, Chhattisgarhi, Goni, Halwa or Halbi, Hindi, Kavar, Khairwar, Khadiya, Koli, Korwa, Korku, Kuruk or Orao, Majhi, Mawasi, Maria, Muria, Munda, Nageshia, Panika, etc. Jharkhand, we have Bengali, Bidhod, Birjia or Asuri, Bhumij, Hindi, Ho, Khadiya, Khortha, Koda or Koda, Kurmali, Kuruk or Orao, Malto, Mundari, Nagpuri, Panchparganiya, Sadri, Santali, Urdu, etc. In Manipur, we have various Tibeto-Burman languages. For example, Aimol, Anal, Chiru, Chothe, Gangte, Mar, Inpui, Kabui, Kharam, Khoibu, Khoirao, Khoireng, Kom, Kuki, Lamkang, Liangmai, Lushai or Mizo, Mao, Manipuri, Maram, Maring, Moyon, Mongsang, Nepali, Paite, Paumai, Purum, Simte, Sukte, Tangkhol, Tarao, Thado Kuki, Waifei, Zemi, Zou, etc. In Nagaland, as we know, we have the major Naga languages, for example, Angami, Ao, Chakru or Chokri, Chang, Kheza, Khienmungam, Konyak, Kuki, Liangmai, Lotha, Phom, Pochuri, Rengma, Sangtam, Sema or Sumi, Yimchungre, Zemi, etc. Then in Odisha, we have Bhatri, Binjia, Bhumiz, Bhunjia, Bhuya, Birhod, Bonda or Remo, Deshia, Gatta or Didai, Gutob or Bodo Gadwa, Gorum or Parenga, Halbi, Ho, Juang, Khadiya, Kisan, Konda or Kubi, Koya, Kui, Kuvi or Kond or Jatapu, Manda, Munda, Mundari, Odia, Parji or Dhruva, Pengo, Santali, Savara, etc. West Bengal, we have Bengali, Bhumij, Bhutia, Chakma, Dhimal, Ho, Koda or Koda, Lepcha, Kuruk or Orao, Mru, Munda, Odia, Nepali, Santali, Toto, Urdu, etc. Now, let's look at the multilingual situation in India. You must be aware that in every census, the data is also given for people who speak other than their mother tongues. So, what we have seen right now was the number of mother tongues and the languages. But as I mentioned already, that India is a multilingual country, and you will not find even one person, or hardly you will find one person who doesn't speak another language other than his or her own mother tongue. So, as it is evident in this figure, you will see among the scheduled languages also, we have high percentage of bilingualism or multilingualism. That means people who speak more than two or three languages. So, Assamese speakers, you will see there that 32.25% speak two languages, they are bilingual. And among the Assamese speakers, 14.47 are trilingual or they speak more than three languages. Bodo bilinguals, we have 57.38, and trilingual, we have 18.64. Dogri, we have 59.44% as bilinguals and 26.49 as trilingual. Gujarati, we have 36.25 who speak two languages, 14.25 speak more than two languages, three or more than three languages. Similarly, you can see Kannada, we have bilinguals 28.44, trilinguals 12.15. Kashmiri, we have bilinguals 39.21 and trilinguals 15.55. Konkani, we have 74.38% people who speak two languages, 47.18% speak three languages or more, and so on. You can look at the chart and see the percentage of bilinguals and trilinguals among the scheduled languages of India out of 22. It's not true that we have bilinguals and trilinguals only among the speakers of scheduled languages. We also have bilinguals and trilinguals, people who speak two or more languages, or three languages and more than three languages. So, as you can see, among the non-scheduled languages, also high percentage of people are bilinguals or multilinguals. For example, among the Adis, 54.42% know two languages. Then we have 33.56% who know three languages or more than three languages. Anal, you can see 75.54% are bilinguals, and 34.06% are trilinguals. Angami, 56.10 speak two or more languages, 22.50 speak three or more languages, and so on. As you can look at the chart and see that how many people speak at least two languages, and many of them speak three or more than three languages among the non-scheduled speakers languages of India. So, I have given the examples from various states: Lepcha from Sikkim, Liangmai from Manipur, Limbu again from Sikkim, Lotha from Nagaland, Mizo from Mizoram, Malto from Bihar, Jharkhand, Maram from Manipur, Meghalaya, Maring from Nagaland, Manipur, Miri, Mishing from Arunachal Pradesh, and so on. Now, multilinguality in India also has many other dimensions. So, what we mean by that is that the languages are classified or in terms of whether they are included in the 8th schedule of the Indian Constitution or not. So, right now we have 22 languages which are listed in the 8th schedule of the Indian Constitution. And these languages which are listed in the 8th schedule of the Constitution are in fact major languages of India, and they are spoken by a large number of people in the concerned states. For example, the Assamese language is one of the scheduled languages, and you will find that people in Assam, where this language is primarily spoken, so many other language groups, many other speech communities also use Assamese. Similarly, if you talk of Tamil as a scheduled language, so it's not that only in Tamil Nadu people speak Tamil, you can find Tamil speakers in other states as well. So there are thousands of Tamil speakers in Karnataka, in Andhra Pradesh, and even other parts of country. So they are the major languages, and it is expected, and the census has also pointed out that people more or less in all the states know the respective scheduled languages that are primarily spoken in that region. In 1951, we had in 8th schedule 14 languages. That was the time. In 1950, we got the constitution, and some languages which were to facilitate the official business of the government, especially the central government, the union government, and the correspondence and other business that would take place between states and the center, to facilitate that, we had 14 languages listed in the 8th schedule in 1951, and we had Assamese, Bengali, Gujarati, Hindi, Kannada, Kashmiri, Malayalam, Marathi, Odia, Punjabi, Sanskrit, Tamil, Telugu, and Urdu. You will see that Urdu is also listed here, and Sanskrit also is listed there. So there were various reasons why these languages were included in the 8th schedule, and one of those reasons very valid reasons were that Sanskrit was a stateless language. It was not a major language of any particular region. So, and also Sanskrit represented the tradition, culture, and identity of India. That's why Sanskrit was included in the 8th schedule. Similarly, Urdu in 1951, it was included because Urdu is considered style of Hindi. The difference between Hindi and Urdu is that they are written into different scripts, and apart from vocabulary, there are not many differences between Hindi and Urdu. So Urdu also at that time was a stateless language, so that was also included in the 8th schedule. And there were amendments made in the Constitution of India at various times, and on the basis of that, from 14, we had then 4 languages added, so we got 18, and in 2003, we had another amendment, and finally, we had 22 scheduled languages as of now. And they are Assamese, Bengali, Bodo, Dogri, Gujarati, Hindi, Kannada, Kashmiri, Konkani, Maithili, Malayalam, Manipuri, Marathi, Nepali, Odia, Punjabi, Sanskrit, Santali, Sindhi, Tamil, Telugu, and Urdu. Apart from the scheduled languages, let's talk about the mother tongues that are included under or grouped under the scheduled languages. So if you count all of them, then there are total 234 identifiable languages and mother tongues which have returned 10,000 or more speakers each at the All India level. So of these, 93 mother tongues have been grouped under the scheduled languages, 22 scheduled languages, and 141 mother tongues under the non-scheduled languages. Thus, for example, we have Bengali, Hajong, Rajbangshi grouped under the Bengali language. We have Avadhi, Bagheli, Brajbhasha, Churahi, Garhwali, Harauti, Hindi, Khadi Boli, Malvi, Sirmauri, Surgujia, etc. grouped under the language Hindi. We have Kashmiri, Kishtwari, Siraji grouped under the Kashmiri language, and so on. Then The one remaining 141 mother tongues are grouped under the non-scheduled languages. Thus, for example, we have Bhauri, Barel, Bhili or Bhilodi, Gamti or Gavit, Mauchi, Rathi, Warli, Wagri, etc., grouped under the language Vili or Vilodi, Dorli, Goni, Maria, Muria, etc., grouped under the Goni language, Bhoi Khasi, Khasi, Panar or Sinteng, etc., grouped under the Khasi language, Apatani, Bangni, Nisi, Tagin, grouped under the language Nisi, also known once upon a time as Dafla, and so on. In addition to the scheduled and non-scheduled languages and mother tongues spoken by more than 10,000 persons each, we have hundreds of mother tongues and languages spoken by fewer than 10,000 speakers each. And as I mentioned, that the Census of India does not publish the data on the names of those mother tongues and the number of speakers for all those mother tongues. And those mother tongues include Birhod, Birjia, Chiru, Dhimal, Khelma, Khoirao, Lamgang, Mizu, Nevari, Nihali, Ong, Singpho, Sunwar, Toda, Toto, Uchai, etc. So there are hundreds of mother tongues which are actually spoken by fewer than 10,000 persons each, and that's why they are not listed. The data on those languages and mother tongues are not published by the Census of India. Now let's look at the official languages of India. In terms of official languages also, India has a peculiar situation. We don't have only one official language in any state, in all the states or for the entire country. As I mentioned, that we have 22 scheduled languages meant for official purposes listed in the Constitution of India. Then the states also decide on the official languages in the respective state. So, as the education language is also in concurrent list, so states also have power. They are empowered to make their own policies, their own rules for making a language official or unofficial or non-official language, which language can be used in education, which language can be used in judiciary, in lower level of judiciary, which language will be used in mass media, and which scripts will be used by which language. These things are broadly decided by the respective states. So this is the situation in India. We have in our states various languages and mother tongues which are used as official languages for official purposes of the state. We have in Arunachal Pradesh English, Assam, Assamese, Bodo, Bengali, Andhra Pradesh, Telugu and Urdu, Andaman and Nicobar English, Bihar, Hindi and Urdu, Chandigarh, we have English, Chhattisgarh, Chhattisgarhi, Delhi, Hindi, Punjabi, Urdu, Daman and Diu, English and Gujarati. Then we have Dadra and Nagar Haveli, English and Gujarati. In Gujarat, we have Gujarati, Goa, Konkani, Himachal Pradesh, Hindi, Haryana, Hindi, Jammu and Kashmir, Urdu, Jharkhand, Hindi, Urdu, Khadiya, Ho, Kodokh, Santali, Mundari, Nagpuri, Panchparganiya, Kurmali and Khorta. And now recently two more languages are going to be included there, and they are Bengali and Odia. Karnataka, we have Kannada. Kerala, we have Malayalam. Lakshadweep, the official language is Malayalam. Manipur, Manipuri. Lakshadweep, Malayalam. Then Manipur, we have Manipuri, I have already mentioned that. Mizoram, we have Mizo. Meghalaya, we have English, Khasi and Garo. Madhya Pradesh, we have Hindi. Maharashtra, Marathi. Nagaland, English. Odisha, Odia. Punjab, Punjabi. Puducherry, which was known as Pondicherry earlier, Tamil, Telugu and Malayalam. Then Rajasthan, we have Hindi. Sikkim has many official languages. So in addition to English and Nepali, we have Newari, Lepcha, Bhutia, Limbu, Gurung, Sherpa, Tamang, Rai, Sunwar and Tamang. Tamang I have repeated here, so Tamang occurs only once. Tripura, we have Bengali and Kokborok. Tamil Nadu, we have Tamil. Uttarakhand, we have Hindi and Urdu. Uttar Pradesh, we have Hindi and Urdu. West Bengal, we have Bengali, Nepali, Urdu, Santali, Odia, and Punjabi written in Gurmukhi script. So in India, we don't only have hundreds of mother tongues and languages, we also have various indigenous scripts in India. And not all mother tongues and languages are written in the same script. Some scripts are used to write more than one language, and some scripts are used to write only one language. So in terms of number of scripts also, India is really rich. So we have scripts like Assamese, which is primarily used for the Assamese language spoken in Assam. Then we have Bengali. Many other languages are also written in Bengali other than Bangla. Vishnupriya Manipuri is written in Bengali script. We have Devanagari. Devanagari is used to write Hindi, Maithili, Bhojpuri, Maghi, Rajasthani, Marathi, and Konkani as well, among the known languages and mother tongues. Divehi or Thana, that script is used for the language of Lakshadweep. Then Gujarati is used to write Gujarati and various other mother tongues in Gujarat. Gurmukhi is primarily used for Punjabi. Then Kannada, which is used in Karnataka to write the Kannada language. Koinch Breshe, a lesser known language, a mother tongue, which is spoken by only few hundred persons in Sikkim, known as Sunwar or Mukhiya, that uses this script. We have Rong, which is used by Lepcha in Sikkim. We have Srizunga, the script used by Limbu in Sikkim. We have Maitei Mayek, the script used by Manipuri or Maitei in Manipur. Malayalam is used to write Malayalam. Newari is used to write the language known as Newari, or also known as Pradhan in Sikkim. So they use Newari script. Odia is primarily used for the Odia language in Odisha, and some other mother tongues also in Odisha use the Odia script. We have Olchiki, also known as Olchemet, and that script is used primarily by the Santali language in West Bengal, Odisha, Jharkhand, and some other parts of country. Tamil is used to write Tamil. Tamik is used to write Tamang in Sikkim. Telugu is used to write Telugu in Andhra Pradesh. We have Persian Arabic script, which is used to write Kashmiri in Kashmir, Jammu and Kashmir, Urdu, and also Sindhi. Of course, Sindhi is written in two scripts, Devanagari and Persian Arabic. And then we also have Roman script, which is used to write many languages in India, especially in Northeast India. So languages like all the Naga languages. So we have Angami, Ao, Lotha, Sangtham, Phom, they all use Roman. Some languages, Tibeto-Burman languages in Manipur, like Waifei, Kom, Mao, Paite, and many other languages, they use Roman there. In addition to these scripts, we also have some other scripts in India, and they have not been recognized by the state, and some mother tongues continue to write in the scripts of the region. For example, Assamese, Odia, or Devanagari, they use. But some have developed some scripts, and some also have some indigenous, very old traditional script. For example, in Arunachal Pradesh, there is a language which uses the script known as Liktai, that is used by the Khamti language in Arunachal Pradesh. Then we have another language in Tripura known as Mog or Mag. They use the Arakanese script based on a Cambodian script. So we can see from this discussion that India is really a multilingual and multicultural country. We have more than thousand of mother tongues, and many of them are also languages because they have become part of judiciary, education, mass media, and various other formal domains. That's why they have become language. But the Indians have never had problem with so many languages and mother tongues. We hardly find that people fight for only their own language and always disregard the others' languages. And as a result, what has happened in India, you will see that Hindi is spoken by officially, according to Census of India, by about 42 or 43 crore Indians. But you go to any part of India, you'll find that people who do not know English or who do not know a major regional language of that part, they converse in Hindi. We have many other link languages as well in India. So in Nagaland, there are 16 major tribes and they have their independent languages, distinct languages. And when they converse among themselves, when they hold conversations, when they need to talk to each other, they use a pidgin language known as Nagamese, which is based on the Assamese language of Assam. So we never had any problem. You go to any part of India, for example, Hindi has about 48 mother tongues as of now, and you will see that it's not there is not a clear-cut boundary that Avadhi has ended here and Bhojpuri has started, or Chhattisgarhi has started somewhere and it has abruptly ended and some other variety has started. So people can manage the dialect continuums. The dialects are never very clear-cut, that they don't have clear-cut boundary. So people can manage to speak with each other because the dialects have some similarity, the varieties have similarity, and where the common dialects are not available, the common languages are not available, then, as I mentioned, Hindi or some other variety or some other regional language is used in that particular area. So we have had a very congenial society in terms of mother tongues and languages. They have all existed very peacefully and will continue to do so in future also. That's all what I had to say regarding the linguistic diversity in India. Thank you.